Nyambura Kamunya. We are in Laikipia, Kenya. I have been living here for the last 23 years. I have been farming until I decided to make it more serious. And that is when I met Max, and he introduced me to permaculture. And I want to welcome you to my farm to see the changes I have made for the last 2 years. Welcome. This family land is about 15 acres. And initially, we used to have cows, and we used to grow maize on this land, you can see here, and beans. And then we used to graze cows along this place. There was overgrazing, and the crop yield was very low. Every year, the crop yield dropped. It is until I met Max that he advised me on methods of grazing, making paddocks, and allowing the grass to grow, because this is robust grass for animals. And then we let the animals go freely, feed freely on the grass, they overgraze such that there is not enough to feed the animal. But when I met Max and he advised me on making paddocks, I took that advice seriously. And now I do not graze the cows here directly. I have allowed that grass to grow. And now we have some food for the animals when all this other food is gone. So right now, where we have been growing a lot of maize, this has been converted to grazing land. You can see animals grazing down there. I have increased the number of sheep, and we are also in the process of increasing the number of cows. As I said earlier, before I learned permaculture, I used to grow only one type of crop. But now I have a variety of crops on the same piece of land. As you can see, I said I have millet. I have two varieties of millet, one for animal consumption, another one for human consumption, and they are all growing on the same piece of land. I also have pumpkins inside there. I have potatoes. And I recently harvested peas and beans, and all the foods are doing good, because I've learned from permaculture that when you mix crops, they don't fight for nutrients. What they do is that they supplement for each other. Some foods put in the soil some nutrients the others do not have, and some crops need some nutrients the others do not have. So it has been working well. At the same time, now the insects are not attracted to only one type of crop. There are so many crops, and there are also some weeds that I have not been uprooting, like the Mexican marigold, which has a repelling smell. This smell repels insects. And yes, the farm is doing good. The yield is higher, and I also have almost everything I need concentrated in the same piece of land. On this piece of land, I have not used any pesticides. I've not used any fungicides. I've not used any fertilizers. It's all natural. And the food is doing good. Why I don't use pesticides and fungicides on this piece of land is because I have mixed crops. I have dania, that is an insect repellent. I also have Mexican marigold, that is also an insect repellent. I also have sunflower that attracts insects and bugs away from the maize. I also have millet that attracts insects and bats away from maize, so the maize is protected and I do not need the pesticides and the insecticides. This land is not over-cultivated because for weeding, I just uproot the weeds and drop them on the ground. Some of the weeds become, they become mulch, and others just die away to become manure. And that's how I have managed to improve the soil quality and to retain the soil nutrients. So with continued good management, I expect better yields every year. The reason why I don't use chemicals on my farm is because it is healthy. It is very unhealthy to eat spread kales, spread fruits, spread maize, but when it is not sprayed and when it is naturally grown, it is good for my health and for the health of those people who share my food with. So I am totally uncomfortable with chemicals, and I would like to continue use the natural methods of farming. Another kitchen garden, because it is near water, so I am able to grow food here even during the dry season. You can see I'm holding a tomato fruit from the tomato tree. We have butternut and it's fruiting there. We have onion, we have sunflower, moti trees, more indigenous fruits, some bananas, more amaranth, we have saga around, we have kales, we have some, we have an acacia tree here. Birds brought the seeds and I retained the tree because it is friendly to the soil. I also have a passion fruit growing near here. We have some more kale, some more bananas, and I'm also growing sunflower. Sunflower has just germinated because near here I have the beehives and I want the bees to have enough of nectar every other day. So every time I have new sources of nectar germinating, like the sunflower, like the saga, and this type of farming is interesting. You have almost everything you need in a small portion of land, and the labor is minimized. The labor is reduced completely, but you get almost everything you need from a small portion of land. Okay, we have a homemade beehive here. Permaculture is very beneficial to beekeeping because you do not use chemicals that kill bees. And also, in permaculture, you have a variety of crops that provides nectar to the bees round the year. When one crop is not flowering, the other one is flowering. And you have crops in the farm around the year, so they have enough supply of food, of nectar, all around the year. So the yield is much higher and the benefits are good. The honey is also of a higher quality because you have variety. It's not from one type of flower, it's from a variety of flowers. So the honey is also of a higher quality. The animals rest overnight. You can see the sheep here and the cows there. They are well protected with a fence. And I have some chicken sharing the same cow shed with the sheep and cows. The chicken benefit from the animal droppings, and they also pick insects from the animals. At night, the chicken will be locked inside here for safety, And this is where I collect the manure I use to improve the farm soil with. I have seen so much on the farm today, and we shall be seeing much more in the future. So thank you so much for visiting my farm, and welcome next time.